So welcome back, Nana here, and then we are into the next session. The second session, I think, is the sixth day, I think. Sixth weekend, actually. I will go ahead on this now. We are into the consigned inventory part. So let me go there and share the screen. So if you see this now, we are seeing this online quantity. So now 120 quantities have been received, and then the supplier is the owner. Let us say I am now going to transfer to regular some 55 quantities. So let me transfer to regular 55 quantities and click on it. So click on done now. We will now perform a transfer to regular for this 55 quantities. Click on done now. So we want to use the 55, so we are now transferring it. So on the consigned inventory, fine, go down. So here we can now say create. Transfer to owned, actually. Right? In eBus, it is known as a transfer to regular. Here, it is known as a create transfer to owned, actually. We can even send it back to the consigned also. Create transfer to consigned also is available. So both the things are basically available. So you can even do the back to consigned or transfer to owned. And click on the create transfer to owned now. So create transfer to owned now. And click on plus. So create transfer to owned transaction. Click on plus now. You are now getting it. Somebody is putting a message. So please read it. And then if it is for me, you just please give me a note. B0130, and then I will now give a tap. I will now choose the transfer test now. So sub inventory, fine. Make a search of this. I click on search now. Fine, I'm not putting this information and then give a search. So this much is available. And click on select it and then go down. So make a search and then click on apply and then click on OK. So by which it will be populated, the line will be populated. We made a search on the item actually. I'm not showing this much is up. So out of 120, how much you want to transfer? I will now put, let us say, a quantity of, let us say, 55. So 55, I want to transfer. So 55. So now what happens? It will be 65 will be with him now. 55 is ours actually. 55, I'm transferring it. So click on it and then click on submit. So we are not transferring it now. Fine. Well, that is 9:53 p.m. actually. Fine. So 10 o'clock approximately. So after 2 hours, we can now create a consumption base because what happens? The 27th is getting closed actually. Click on submit. So you know. 9:53 p.m. of Japan time actually of 27th. So once when 28 dawns, then we can run the consumption advice actually. Click on submit. So by which what happens? The 55 quantities is now getting transferred to this place.
So this was a lot item, right? So do we need to enter the lot number here?
Oh God. I think we have to enter the lot number. Okay. The transaction paused with no issues. Probably it's only a lot control, and so only one lot was there. So probably if multiple lots are there, we may have to enter the lot also. I'm not sure about it.
Okay.
Go there, click on it, and then go to the manage item quantities, and then have a look at the item now. It's a B0130, and then give a tab. Go there, and then click on search now. Click on search. It now shows you 120. Fine, go there, click on it now. I'll expand it. And then the consigned details has to come now. It's not coming. Item details are there. So let me minimize it and then expand it. The consigned details has to come. No, it's not coming. The consigned details has to come. It's coming at the subunit level and not the lot level. No, fine. Previously at the lot level it came. Now at the subunit level it is coming. Fine, click on the consigned details and go there. Now he has got. He is the owner of only 65 quantities and not 120 quantities. So he has got a consigned online of what 65. So previously in the lot it was coming. Now the subunit level is coming now. So he owns 65 now. 55 is ours. So now what happens? We have to go and then run the consumption advice. So once when the consumption advice is run, the system will automatically create what happens. These concurrents will be running automatically. The pay on the zip. The payables open interface import and then the invoice will be there. So similarly, what happens, it will be importing it in Fusion. It is not so. It will be doing the import also automatically upon consumption advice successful. Successful consumption advice, what happens, it will be automatically importing it and then you can now see the invoice in the base tables, but not today, only tomorrow. Go there. We will not try to run it today itself. We will not see what happens now. Go to the tools and then go to the scheduled process. So create consumption advice and go right. Click on schedule. Create cons. We are running this concurrent. grid consumption advice, and click on OK now. So click on OK. Now the supplier I'm putting it as what? B01, and then give it app con supplier. I'm going to put it. I'll put the concept. So site, I'm putting it now. Search site two. Okay. And then display lot and serial numbers. Okay, fine. We'll not display it. Lot is there. And group by transaction type. Okay, fine. I'll do it. Create consumption advice report also. It does not create the report also. So I go there. Click on submit now. Fine. This will not fail because what happens is today's date. Only when you run it tomorrow, it will be coming actually. So if it runs successfully, it will be doing the import also automatically. Great consumption advice. Now printing is not.
Initially, when we did the miscellaneous receipt, we did it.
We never made the miscellaneous receipt. We are now bringing it from supplier, so no need to make any
miscellaneous. Okay, yeah, sorry. When we brought from supplier, did we bring the material into FGS subinventory or some other subinventory?
We did on some asset subinventory, FGS only I put it. And that only has to be debated actually. Fine. Go on the feed and then debate it and then see whether it is the expense subinventory or asset subinventory. People are saying that it can even receive on asset also, but I'm not sure.
But then later we move the material from consigned to...
We are not moved anywhere. We only drawn now. Fine. On the same subinventory itself, we are transferring it to regular stock. So it's still on the FGS only.
Okay.
Fine. On the same subinventory, we are transferring it. Later on, you have to move it with the subinventory transfers to your production areas. That is not coming in this part now, basically. In this cycle, it is not coming. After having transferred it, that becomes eligible for usage, and then you will now perform a subinventory transfers and then move it to your shop floor subinventory actually.
Okay, so we have to do one more transaction. Okay.
Yeah, we have to make one more transaction for using it. Actually, that is not part of this cycle. Actually, so I am not done it. So I am not.
So we change only ownership of those items.
Yeah, we change only the ownership of the 60-way quantities now. 60-way quantities, we are the owner, and then he's not the owner. In EBIS, what happens? It will not say what is our quantity, what is their quantity. Also here, it is not showing that now. It shows only the consigned.
We don't set rules here, is it? Like EBIS, we set the consumption transfer rules, right?
Yeah. Yeah, here there are so many rules are there. Consumption transfer rules are there. Fine. Where here there is no rule at all.
Anak, one question. Like, can we pick the item from consumption subinventory and ship it directly? Like, the item will get consumed the moment you ship and ship.
No. Yeah. That is what I was saying. That's what Vikram was saying. You have a consumption transaction rules. So okay. Upon transferring it, what happens? It will be getting shifted to one of your subinventories basically. Through that.
Yeah, just before shipping it or issuing it out, it will be transferred so that till the last minute the
owner. But I don't know, even NIB is also how to do that now. Fine. The consumption transaction rules, I don't know. Upon transferring it, what happens? It has to be brought to our subinventory. So that consumption transaction rules will now do it. But I don't know how to do that actually. And here, there is no such concept at all. I don't know. It may be there, but I'm not sure about it. Fine. When I refer all the notes of everything in the for the fusion, it is not telling me anything about the consumption transaction rules. Actually. Maybe it may be there. I'm not sure about it. Okay, fine. Now, the consumption advice has run and then it will not create anything at all because only tomorrow if you run it, it will not create. Upon successful consumption, what happens? It will be importing the invoice also, but it has not imported. And so what happens? It will not run. And go there, click on the output now. And go there, click on output. It will be having nothing as such. We'll now have a look at the output now. We'll now save it. Show. And click on it. Open it up and then see. Take a copy of it. Close it. Minimize it and then put in a Word file and then have a look at it now. It is not showing anything at all. This is actually a report and it has got no meaningful information there. Asynchronous mode, all these things are there. Come on here. No, see some other output on the Zoom. Print the consumption advice report. It is giving a nonsense. I don't know whether anything else is there or not. And there's one more thing out there. I'll now see this file. I tried that file now. I will now see this file. Somebody told the word wrap also. It will not clearly say that what happens, it has not done anything at all. Nothing has been done actually. I also same thing. I'll not go to the other one and then see this. Moment. Go to the create consumption advice itself. This is important. Now look at this. So create consumption advice. The one. Look at it. So that gives the information. Copy that. Minimize it. So the number of consumption basically is zero, and then process is zero, and nothing is done. So at around 10 o'clock India time, what happens? It will be early morning in Japan actually. So at the time we'll again run it. At the time, what happens? So somebody remind me at 10 o'clock that what happens the other day. So at the time when you do it, what happens? You don't have the consumption advice created actually.
So in the manage item quantities when we queried earlier, it showed 65 quantity, right?
Only on the consumption advice. So if you see this now in this place, on the consumption advice, what happens? It showed.
Nana sir, there was one more output file. Could you please open that?
One second. This is the place. 120 is only shown. Whereas in email, it will not show you clearly how much is yours, how much belongs to him now. Fine. That way it shows. Here.
Okay.
Nana, the create transfer one program, are we transferring it to any other sub-inventory at least? Or
transfer to what happens? Transfer to one is same sub-inventory only. We are not transferring it to any other sub-inventory. It gets transferred on the same. That is why what happens, we'll be having a physical Lakshman Rekha. Whatever is being crossed is ours actually on the same sub-inventory. On the same sub-inventory. We have a Lakshman Rekha also. Practically a Lakshman Rekha is there. And then if Sita crosses the Lakshman Rekha, she is mine. So likewise what happens, if we have a Lakshman Rekha. So whatever crosses the Lakshman Rekha, it is ours.
It's like drawing a line logically.
Yes. Drawing a line logically, actually.
That's why in R12, right, they clearly say which transactions create consumption.
I couldn't understand where exactly is that. I don't have a good documentation on consigned inventory. So that is why what happened. I don't understand.
Sales in EBS, Nana, sales order issue also creates consumption. Mm-hmm. So we have configured. We can directly, we get customer orders in SOI inventory. Exactly. And then we directly sell it to customers.
Consigned inventory on sales orders, I am unable to understand now.
Sales order issue will create a consumption address.
If anybody has got any document or anybody can take a session on this, it will be great for the sales actually. So this is what is, and then I will now show you one document on this now. Fine, go there. If you click on this now, fine. The 14th is already uploaded now.
If we run the all inventories value report, the consignment inventory transfer to us will only be shown in the AIV or
no, the consignment. You run the report, whether the transfer to regular will also show or only consumption advice will show. I'm not sure about it. Fine. Again, no idea at all. I mean, you're in the costing only. So again, what happens? You only have to have a look at it. Fine. Good question, but I don't have the answer. She is saying that what happens, only the transfer to regular will not show in your thing, or the consumption advice only will show on your costing part. Right? Good question. I don't know. Here, what happened? What I came here for? What? Yeah, I will now go to the confusion SCM training, and then go to the e-business now foundation, and then I go to the purchasing, and then go to the auto purchasing, and then go to the DeFi now. So here, what happens? I got one more document from one of my students actually. There's the consigned inventory configuration. We are now seeing the process now. If you go to the configuration, it will explain you a lot on this. How to do this. So a lot of, not this one. So I'm sorry, not this one. This I created a procedure actually. I only created a procedure actually. Consigned inventory. I think this is the one. This, what about the PPT actually. This is the one we have seen now. And then this, I created my own now. So click on the consigned inventory. It's like in a big topic. Fine. You have to do a lot of R&D on this now. So you can understand it actually. Why it's not showing me? Yeah. PowerPoint is coming on. So enability. This is done by one guy. He has given a lot of explanation on this one. Go there. A lot of explanation at the bottom now. Keep on reading it now. Setups. He has not done it for the e-biz basically. create the sub inventory, create the sub inventory, item definition. Item definition has got an attribute there, and supplier insight is now created. Sell billing, pay on is now selected now. Go there. Invoice summary level, create blanket purchase agreements. Every explanation is now excellent actually. Creating an approved supply list. Here ASL BPA is required actually in use now. So don't follow this procedure, but later on what happens, you can now see now, create approved supply list. So define consumption transaction rules. This is where I couldn't understand this now. So the consumption transaction rules will now automatically transfer it to your destination subunit or what exactly it is now. I'm unable to understand this now. And then the consumption transaction rules is explained here actually. He's explained it. And then again, consumption transaction rules is now further explained actually. Go through this now. And then purchasing the consigned material, how it's doing. Plenty of information is there, fine. It explains you even the complex ones also in this. Query material status. So go through this and then the consumption advice is now getting generated. You got a lot of things on this. Invoicing, pay on order invoice, concurrent program, purchasing order information transactions.
So in the...
I have a quick question in this that we are creating the standard purchase order in this case from BPA. But if BPA is not global, we cannot create a standard purchase order.
You see, by nature, all BPAs are global in Fusion actually. There is no such a local BPA. Fine, everything is a global BPA by nature.
Yeah, no, in EBS.
And like EBS, what happens, I don't know whether we have to create a, we are creating a local BPA also. From the forms form, we can very well, not necessarily that.
Yes, we can create a local BPA. Yeah. So in this presentation, which you have shown, we have created a standard purchase order.
Yeah, BPA, against BPA will be giving it. Right? This is what the thing is. Now. If you go there, first what happens, you will know how what the ASL BPA created. Then afterwards, we will now create a purchase order. Actually. SPO will be created.
So how purchase order is created against BPA?
That is, I don't know. That's what in sales, I don't know. Fine. Somebody has to say, they're all done.
Actually. No, Ravindra, I can explain. So basically, that's what I'm saying. We don't create manually POs for consigned inventory. It comes through forecast. It has to be a supplier collaboration module, which wherein supplier has access to our system and it places the POs. Okay, so yes, in wherever I'm working in Arrow, we don't do any releases against BPA.
Oh, yeah.
So we always do standard purchase order and reference the BPA so that the price gets referenced onto the purchase order. That's it.
How is the standard purchase order created referring BPA?
Yeah, the standard purchase order is actually created basically based on the supplier forecast. We have a concept called supplier forecast where we share our supply forecast, our supplies, whatever the net supplies we got from the ACP, we directly share it with our supplier. What is net supply? Net supply is nothing but any planned orders generated in ACP that is new buy, or it can be purchase requisitions. These are actually calculated as demand for supplier. So we share our supply schedule to the supplier, and supplier will in turn generate sales order directly. Okay, when he generates sales order, when it comes through B2B, B2B is a business-to-business mapping process where they use Rosetta Net standard and they map. When the sales order comes into our system, it converts into a PO automatically.
Oh.
So there is no concept of manual creation at all.
Yeah, I am not demonstrating the manual PO, but what Kiram is saying that everything is automatic through the supplier forecast, and then what happens, that will be coming up automatically. So that's why what I'm understanding, you have to do a lot of understanding on this. Now, fine. Only a basic concept is now explained here. Now, fine. It's in reality, what happens is a very much complex one. Good, Vikram. So if you have any documents, Vikram, to share to others, what happens, you can send it to me. I will now share it with participants. Fine.
Our end-to-end process is there. Probably, most of the cases, it could be that only because supplier is always going to replenish the inventory in our area based on our demand only. So it's all going to work in a planning system. Okay, any individual purchasing, I don't think they will go for a consigned inventory, I'm not sure. But in semiconductor, any distribution industry you take, consigned inventory is a mandatory process. Without that, it cannot work. Because every supplier will come and dump materials or parts into our warehouse. And upon consumption, we directly create consumption advice to the supplier.
Is there any search here that only our material has to be shown? No. There is no such criteria. Maybe if you add fields and then try, and then Shafiq, you can add and then try. I don't want to have the entire 120 being shown there. No. I want only our material. Fine. In the bottom, it is showing. He is now owning 65. Where is our stock? I
don't know. View item quantity by. Can you select view item quantity search results? On the view item quantity below the search results.
Below the search results.
There is view item
quantity. Availability. That is a different one. That will be seen.
No, just about that. Just about that.
The okay. View item quantity by item locator service.
Okay. Okay.
Okay, man, good. So
this view item availability is ATP, is it? View item availability is ATP call, is it?
Yeah. We'll be discussing about it in order management, actually. It is ATP call, actually. Yes, very correct. We'll be discussing about it in order management, actually. Again, that's a complex topic. Okay, this completes the discussion on what happens consigned inventory, and then we'll again run the consumption advice at the day dawns in Japan, actually. Now, I will now give you an introduction to TAD, actually. I learned it somewhere other by discussing with the financial guys. They have not taught me fully. Whatever I have learned, I will now teach you on the consigned inventory, on the TAD, transaction accounting definition, next topic. So here, what happens, I will now, first of all, come out of it now. I will now go to my instance where, what happens, I know, given the accounting there now, and here everything is vision accounts, I have not done anything at all. This now. So I will now go to the EBTR and then I will now show it to you. Go to the EBTR. The EBTR, what happens, I have not done the accounting. So it's a G. A1_EMP1 now. So we're going over there. Now, the transaction accounting definition is the one which is a really excellent one, actually. Beautiful one. It is a replacement of SLA, actually. SLA is now replaced by the TAP TAD concept, actually. So I'm now going to introduce you that concept, actually. So before I go there, what happens? I go there and then I click on the Vision SCM training, and then we go to the additional docs and records. And then yesterday we have seen this now. And the last class, what you have seen is this one now, Fusion Purchasing Accounting. So this is what you have seen. So if the end customer wants, what happens, a sub-inventory level accounting, then we have given what? The material account at the sub-inventory level, and then for this also. And you have done it. So for the asset item, fine, asset into asset, what happens, it will be hitting this account, and then asset into expense, this will be hitting this account. And if the end customer do not want this, what I did is I put an end date now. I put an end date and then simulate that org level, it will not pick up. So he may even ask at the sub-inventory level or org level or both also. Some sub-inventories, I want to have some account. When some of the inventories, if he is not given, what happens, it will not pick up from the org level actually. So I have now simulated the 1010. And then similarly for the expense also, expense into asset and expense into now fine, 1004, 1005. So I put an end date now. Now for an asset item, what happens is now coming as 1010, and then for the expense it's now coming as 1006. Let's now make a look over it now. Fine, let's click on it. So let us now have a look at it. So we'll now go to the place and then go to the procurement and then have a look at it first of all. So we go to the procurement and then here you go there and then go to the purchase requisition now. Then have a look at it. Lokesh, are you there? I asked him to join. I don't know whether he has joined or not. Go there and then click on the more task and then click on the enter requisition line. So we are given the 50th item as asset item. Fine, go there. So it's a B0150 is an asset item. Not B01, it's A150. Is an asset item. When you put it, what happens, you'll now get what? As an asset item, what happens, you'll get 1010. And for the expense item, only at the org level, because these two things are now disabled actually. So at the org level, it will not pick up 1010. And then at the org level again, it will not pick up 1006. So if the customer wants at the subunit level also, we have to give it now. And that's what I done it. 1010 is coming. And let us now go and then put the expense item now. Fine. A1, 51 is an expense item. Fine. Go there. Now, what happens, you're getting 1006 actually. It's not coming. So if you add it to the cart and then make a check of it, now fine, click on it. I'm going to delete this line. So delete it. and then I'm going to add it. I click on enter cart. So 1006 has to come now. And then if you go there and then edit it, I'm going to do 1006. Well, oh, come on. Why it's not become 1006 actually? It has to become 1006. On the day it became, na?
Yeah, can you create new request?
I'll now go to the shop now. I'll now go to the more. And then let's now, first of all, delete this now. So click on delete it now. The more and click on enter acquisition line. Maybe since I changed it, what happens? It's not coming anything anymore. So expense, but now it's coming 1006. Maybe on the same line, I'm changing it. It is not, the change is not getting reflected actually. So we are now seeing this thing combined, subinvent level defaulting and then the org level defaulting both as 1006. And then we are now seeing what happens. Employees expense account is coming, whereas I don't know how to set up Infusion now. The guy who has given me a document, one student has given me the document. This is on this now, fine. So if anybody knows about the purchase orders, it will be great actually. Defaulting of accounts in purchasing, once again. 34th one. Yeah. This document has been given by one of my students. He says this is all about requisition actually. This is all about requisition. Fine with that. So it's all done. So requisition wise, he has given everything. All combinations he has given. But for purchase orders, he's not having it actually. And purchase orders also is there. So if I know it, then what happens? I can even do this also. We will try this. I will now give this as an exercise for you. Fine. I will try it. It's not coming actually. I have already given 1007 on the employee's expense, and then for the service items, it is not getting defaulted at all in the purchase order section. Not coming. So that you have to see. Fine. And the requisition is coming. When I put a service item, what happens? 1007 is coming. You see, and the requisition is coming, but not on the purchase orders actually. If you go there, click on what happens, done, and then come out of it. If you go and then do the service items over here, and click on it. That is coming on the requisition. Fine, go there. So click on fixed prices services seven. Fine, drop it down and then make the fixed prices services. And then here you go there and then put the description over here now. Fine, and then put any category over here now. But the service items 1007 is coming. Now what happens? It is now superseded by the what happens if you go there, click on search now. It is now superseded with what? If you go there, click on it. It is now superseded by our manual one. So the manual one of 1002 is coming. So if you go there and then delete the manual one, 1007 will come. So you go there, click on it. And then I go to the edit user update requisition preferences, and then let me delete it now. And let me delete this now. How to delete it? Delete it. And click on delete. So now 1007 will come up. Fine, save and close now. So the manual preferences now done. Fine, go there, click on it, and then go to the enter requisition line. Then go there, and then you go to the fixed prices service. Go there, and then put the category over here. Click on the category, any category, on search. Now 1007 will be coming, not 1002 because that is deleted. So it will not pick up from the employees. So 1007. See, this is a big requirement. Our financial team has done it because in the purchase orders, what happens on the service purchase orders, which is fixed prices and services, it will now pick up from what happened the employees charge account. But I don't know how they have done it now. Hey, somebody is now putting the message in the chat now. And if it is anything meaningful for me, you please read it actually. So this one is a lab exercise for you. I don't know how to do it. We'll not try it, but I don't know where to do it. I refer the MetaLink and then they have given some solution, but that is not working actually for me. So this has to come, and the requisition is coming, whereas in the purchase orders is not coming. Whereas segment wise, what happens doing it is possible now. Fine. If you see this, what happens on the EBIS side, what I have told you is what we can even have what happens a category based charge account that I have to customize in SLA actually. In EBIS. I don't know how to customize in SLA, but I don't know how to customize in Fusion. That too also, my method may not be correct, but I will now teach you whatever I know.
Nana, are you speaking with reference to what you taught last class?
Yeah, last class, of course, yeah.
Okay.
I was talking to what I taught last class, actually.
Okay. So that I didn't attend, so yeah, okay.
So refer the last class one.
So Nana sir, when you speak about, you know, charge account or default expense account, which is getting, you know, generated here in PR, but you mean to say it's not getting generated in PO level, right?
It is not getting generated in PO level. I don't know why it's so.
It should. Because, you know, we have.
In the PR, it's not. PO is not coming now.
Okay.
Charge account is not coming for me.
Yeah. Can you please just give it a try, actually, you know?
Yeah, I'm going to do it. I'm going to try and then I will tell you.
Yeah.
I'm going to try and then I will now fail and then give it to you. Then afterwards, you people have to take it up.
How actually, you know, we have defined it, and you know, it's working.
I will tell you, I'm not teaching you TAD now, fine. I'm going to teach you TAD now. So I'm not going to begin my TAD actually. So what I do is, let us say for anything, fine, whatever is there, I want to have a constant account now. Let us say some constant account I will not take it up. Let us say some account will not take it up now. This place, what is the account we have now? We have how many accounts are there? Okay, in this place, what happens? We have this many accounts now, fine. 1,000. I will not take up some account which is now using the subunitary level now. Fine, that. So let us say 1,004 is the subunit level which I already disabled. So I will not give a constant now. Fine. The charge account has to be constant of 1,004 only. Fine. So it should not be 1,010 or 1,006. Fine. Both asset and expense items, I want to have a constant. So first thing, I will not teach you on that, about how to put a constant now. Then afterwards, what happens? I will not teach you about how to have category-based charge account. And that is the next one I'm going to teach you. So let us now begin with that. 1,004 as a constant. We'll now go on and see. So you go there. Right click and then what happens? Duplicate. So my explanation was not clear. Satya has clearly told that what happens. What I have put on the requisition is coming when the purchase order is not coming. That is the problem for me. So now this is basically what happens, a scope-specific activity. And so what happens? You go there and then go to the scope. And then you go to the set of amendments and then choose the purchasing. So scope specific activity, remember. So the TAD is totally scope specific. The transaction accounting definition is totally scope specific. You can go there and then choose your module. I'm not choosing a module. And then here, what happens? You go there. Purchasing transaction accounting rules is the one that I'm going to do. So before this, what happens if you go there and see duplicate? And then there is one area where you'll be defining the SLA actually. Click on it. I will not go to the setup and maintenance, and I will not define the SLA now. One second. There are two kids are there, so much of a noise will be there from my back end actually. I can't control it. So click here, automatically go there, and then I will not go to the search. Click on search. So manage percentage, sub percentage, lead percentage, options percentage. This is the SLA area. So this is the SLA area. Manage sub ledger accounting options is the one. I click on it. I will now put my this thing over here now. So it's A1 and then give a tab now. I'm now querying the ledger. I click on search now. And then expand it. So there are so many sub ledgers are there. Asset, cash management, cost management, expense, etc. And this is what happens. They go there. And then in this place, you go there. And then I will now choose by purchasing. If I click on the purchasing. In the purchasing, what happens? I will now click on what happens? Accounting options. If I click on the accounting options. In the accounting options, on the edit mode, what happens? I'm now clicking on it. And then here, what happens? You go there. I will now here, what happens? It will be purchasing tab account defaulting will be there. That is the one which will be there. This is the default account. I will now give a save and close. So I made a test of it and then what happens? I go on there. So the purchasing tab defaulting is the one which is there. Now that is used, the default accounting, that is what it is now. This explains about all the default accounting. So like first of all, take it from the subunitary or from the R, or for the expense to asset, what happens, take it from the subunitary or from the R actually. And then these things also, fine. All these things are basically.
So now can you slow it down a little bit? And then, so what you said is you have selected SLA and you're trying to say your account generation, the account. So in e-business suite, we have something called account generator, which is exactly. A local end. And that is what is your the TAD that exactly. You're referring to.
So on your meeting, Srini, you go through the yesterday's last record on the channel okay. Recording.
Right? All right, I'll do that.
Okay. Right? You cannot repeat that over here now.
I am, okay.
You're able to understand it enough, right? To some extent. Now, what happens? I'm now going to populate only 1,004 now. Fine. The default accounting is like this now. The default accounting, I'm going to overwrite. So what I do is, I'll now go there. I'll now overwrite this defaulting with a 1,004. So this is what is, you go there, click on it. In this place, what happens, you choose the procurement area and then you go to the procurement transaction accounting. Now here, what happens, you go to the manage transaction accounting definition. Fine. Go to the TAD. So manage TAD, fine, transaction accounting definitions, I'm opening it up. I'm opening up this now. So let me run it now. What happened? What is the message in the chat? Aha. Okay, okay, fine. Yeah. He's saying that what happens, sir? Satya, you can even pass it on to others also. Fine. You. Yeah, I'll go there. Click on it, and then you go there. Go to the financials. I'll again come back now. Go to the procurement now. Go to the procurement. And then in the procurement, what happens, we'll be having this now. Fine. Go to the procurement one. And then I will now click on the manage transaction accounting definitions. And click on it. It has no, it has go there. Manage transaction. Here, what happens, the purchasing accounting defaulting is there. So if you click on it, what happens, it will not show you how the accounts are getting defaulted again. So there are actually six accounts are there as far as purchasing comes on. One is what? You're having an accrual account, you have a charge account, and then you have a variance account. Apart from that, you have a destination charge and destination variance also. So let us say in the purchase order, I am going to make a purchase order for an inventory org, which is what happens, a cross BU. They call this as a cross BU. That is, if it is going to be across BU, if the cross BU is S, what happens, we have to define the destination charge and destination variance also in the purchase order. If it is for the other. So we have around 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 accounts are there. And these accounts have to be defined. And then here, we cannot modify anything at all. In the purchasing tab, what happens, nothing can be modified actually. It is a default one, and then it will be coming. I will be coming to the default a bit later. Now, what I do is, I will not take a copy of it, and then I'm going to modify it. You can only take a copy, and then click on the now. So the default tab, we cannot modify at all. And tab defaulting is not possible. I click on the, it is basically called transaction accounting definition.
I'm able to see only 5 accounts now. Accrual charge, destination variance, and variance.
Okay, only 5. Okay, fine. Sorry. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, 5 only. There are 5 only. I'm sorry. It's only 5. So, accrual charge and variance, and then if it is going to be cross BU, then destination charge and destination variance are also there. Otherwise, you may not have it defined. And then I will not tell you about how they are all done. I will now come to you a bit later. Now, this cannot be what happens modified actually. The seeded ones cannot be modified. You can only have to copy and then modify. Click on that now. Let me create my own tab. Click on it. Let me get on that. I will now select it and then I will now make a copy now. And this is basically duplicate now. And click on duplicate and now make it that. So I will now say what happens is A1 underscore what happens TAD. So transaction accounting definition. And go there. So I will now take a copy of it and then put the short name. Go there. Description also I'm putting it now. Chart of accounts is what? My A1. And then give it tab. Fine. Click on it. So for my chart of accounts, I am now creating my own tag. And that is the one is for all the things now. Click on second close. Provide a value for the short name. Oh god, the uppercase is coming. Big R I L. Okay, then now say A1 underscore tag. It needs to be on uppercase now. Take a bit, I'm not put everything in uppercase. I don't know why they are making it as case sensitive now. So click on save and close by which whatever the A1 tag is now getting created. So the new TAD is ready. So this can be edited actually. Now this becomes editable actually. So my chart of accounts has got 3 segments. One is the company segment, one is the department segment, one is the account segment actually. Fine. It's not exactly clearly visible actually. So the account segment, I'm going to make it only for the charge. Only for the charge account, what happens, I'm going to override it. So these are all the defaults. So the defaults are here now. So the defaults can be overridden at this level only. My individual segments. So let me create my rule and then or now override. Yes. I will right click on that, now duplicate it now, and I'm going to get my own rule. So let me go and then get my rule now. And click on it and then go there. And again, they are all scope specific. And so what happens? You have to go to the purchasing area and then do it now. So the scope specific one will be coming. And then click on it, drop it down.
And so for every BU, do we need to go and define a new TAD or we can reuse the same
BU level? It is not a BU level, it is across BU basically. It can be any level. But you have to go to the procurement area. The procurement area, we have to go on the day. Go there, click on it. Now here, I will now create my rule now, manage accounting rules. So now we have copied my TAD. I have created my own TAD by copying this the default TAD. And then what happens, I go to the accounting, click on the manage accounting rules. And then here, I will now create my own rule now. Click on plus now, file it. So it's what, I will again put A1, because this capitals and other things. I will now say A1 and then what happens? I will now say rule 1. I'm not getting a rule now. I'm going to take off it and then description. The chart of accounts is what A1 and then give it a tab now. And the name, I will now put A1 and then make a search now. Oh, it's a capitals. A1 into consumption. The search must be case insensitive, actually. I don't know why they have made it. So I know for the charge accounts. In this, what happens? Only the charge account, I am going to make a modification. In this place, what happens? The charge account, that is the account, has to be made as a constant now. 1004 constant, I go there. I will not go there. Not the entire combination, but only the segment. I click on the segment. It's a segmental one, drop it down, and then I will not choose the accounting segment. The accounting segment. So here, what happens? There are multiple ways of doing it. Fine, click on plus now. Fine, let me choose a constant. So let me choose a constant. Go there. Is the accounting rule now? Go there. So I will now, what happens? Drop it down. I will not put a constant here to begin with the constant. So I will not put a value and drop it down. I will not choose 1004 here. That's it. My rule is ready. So this constant will be going into the accounting. Fine. The orders. And then click on save and close. Any doubts on this now? Fine. I create a rule. I'll be coming to other part a bit later now. I'm now beginning with the constant. Thank you on save and close.
Now you will associate this rule with the account.
In the TAD, what happens? I will now associate this rule. So here, what happens? I go to the charge account. And then in this place, what happens? I'm going to override this one with this now. I'm now going to override it with this now. Fine. Go then drop it down. And then I will now override. Okay, on search. Fine. I'll now say what happens. Created by application name is what? Capital A1. And then click on search now. I will now override with this rule. Choose it and then click on OK. So this rule is basically for this now. Fine. This rule is basically for this. Subinvent level defaulting, org level defaulting, all these things. And then everything. Now it's all overridden now. Fine. With 1004 actually. It's all overridden. Fine. Go there. So I now put the rule over here. Fine. Go there. Click on it. So direct. Fine. Click on save. Fine. My TAD is now having the different one. Fine. Give a save. And then make it as active actually. And after having it, what happens? I make it as active. And click on activate it. From incomplete, what happens? It will not become active. So the process of activation is complete now. Now it is activated. Now we go there, go to this place now. Go to this place in the subledger accounting. What happens? You go there. It is an activated one and go to the purchasing and then click on edit now. If you edit, all the activated TAD will be shown over here. Drop down. All the activated TAD will be shown here. Where is my activated TAD? And click on search now. I will not go there. And then click on search now. All the activated TAD has shown now. Now my TAD is coming. Click on OK. So I now put it and click on save and close. Now the activity of TAD is now defined as complete. Fine, save and close. Now I will now go on and check on the requisition. Fine, go to the shop area and click on it. I will now check on the requisition. 1004 will be coming for whatever may be the item, whether it is an asset item or expense item or whatever it is. Fine, go to the enter requisition lines. Fine. Anything will be 1004 only. A150 and then give a tab now. This is an asset item. So asset item means what? 1000, what is the thing has to come up and the asset item? The asset item, what do you have to have? 1010 has to come. On the expense, 1006 has to come now. Fine. So here, what happens if you go on and see the tab now and go there? 1004 will be coming. It's 1004. So I will not try to put an expense item also. One of the everything will be 1004. Whatever you put is a constant. Okay. And then go there. Go to the enter requisition line. And then put it A151. And then do it now. Fine. Expense items also. What happens? It will not be 1006. Fine. It will be 1004. So this is a constant way of defaulting. So if you want a constant charge account, what happens is the way. Now the next one is what? Category based account. That is where what happens. Many companies operate upon. For every category, they'll be having a different charge account. So we'll now make a category based charge account. So first let me go and then create a category now. And then the category part, what happens? I have clearly told you, but how to create it now? Fine, we'll click on it. We'll now go to the setup and maintenance. I will again repeat that part now because many people are getting stuck on this now. Fine. Go to the manage percentage, functional percentage, area percentage, kata percentage. I click on it. It's again a big subject, and then only financial guys will know. I will teach you clearly actually. Fine. Whatever I know, I'm teaching it, but that is not sufficient actually. I asked them, they are yaar tumko ye kya zarurat hai na sahab chhod dijiye isko. That is the way they are asking me. Fine. Are yaar, I want to learn, teach me, but they are not teaching me. It's a big subject, and so what happens, they are not teaching me. So select it, and then here what happens, I go there, click on the underscore of the purchasing area. This is a functional area for purchasing now. I click on it, and then let me create a what happens, a category also. Click on the functional area catalog and go there, and then here what happens, I'm going to give a plus. I will now create a what happens a category. I will now say A1 underscore tools I'm going to use it. And tools is the category. Click on the category code, will be coming automatically. By the description, you paste it now, and then click on it. And then click on OK. I now created tools category. If I try to create the same category in some other functional area, it will not allow. I click on save and close now, and tools is now created. AA1 tools is now created. So here, what happens if you go there, and then I will now go to the inventory area and then try to create it now. Where the inventory area. Another functional area, and this now. G4, so many inventories are there. There is one default inventory will be there now. There is a default order entry. So let us then try to go to the order entry and then try to create it now. Order entry is the functional area. The functional area catalog, now. Fine. I click on plus now. And then I will not put the category name over here. New tab. So it shows the error actually. So if a category is created in one functional area, that cannot be repeated in another functional area. That is a problem. Fine. The name is already existing actually. So do you know what you have to do? You have to create what happens in desktop computers. In inventory, you'll be creating a desktop computer category. And then in the purchases, what happens, you'll now say disk underscore comp in purchasing. In order entry, what happens, you'll now say D underscore comp. So different names you have to give, and then you'll be forgetting about what you have given which area.
Can we share it? Share the category code?
I don't know whether it's possible or not. I don't know how to do this now. Anybody?
Sorry. This is Lokesh here.
Share categories is there. Okay, fine. Click on share categories. We'll now see whether it is not sharing or not.
Hello?
Yeah,
Nana sir, Lokesh here, sir. Sir, there is an option called assignments. You can
assignment
have
only for the catalog area, functional area, not for this. Now.
Yeah.
Functional area can be done together now, basically. Lokesh, fine, welcome now. Fine. I need your help on IRTO, yeah, fine, later on. Tomorrow also, if you can come, it will be very good. This guy has implemented more than 10 to 11 implementations. He has done now, fine. He's got a lot of experience now. I invited him. So thanks for joining, Lokesh, now, fine, brother. So now, category, I want to share. How to do it now?
No, that's what. If you go, if you go back, Nana sir, 1 minute.
1 second.
Go back.
Cancel.
Click on cancel.
The AA1 tools, I want to share it with some other catalog actually.
No, it's not about sharing. The main idea of this functional catalog, it is going to be a standard catalog which is assigned or common across multiple. There are two catalogs, like one we have it as functional area catalog and you have it as a product catalog.
Okay.
So product catalog is something which you can have or you can define based upon your requirement. But
yeah, exactly. Area, that is the additional one. Okay.
Yeah, that is an additional catalog. Yeah, functional area catalog where you have something called assignments. What you can do if you want the same thing, for example, say I have a purchasing and an order management and an inventory catalog, all are same or common across all things.
That then I have already defined actually. We can have one catalog across multiple functional areas. That is the best practice and that I have done. So catalog wise, I can share, but category wise, how to do it?
So that's what. So the catalogs and categories are associated with each other. So if you assign the, you can assign it at the catalog level.
Yes.
That your categories will be assigned to that particular catalog. Yeah,
that is what I'm saying. So here what happens, if you have one catalog created for multiple functional areas put together, then what happens, we have to create the categories only one section.
Correct.
Got enough? That is what it is. So that I have already explained previously. So now also what happens, I'm again and again telling you, please, again, what happens, create multiple, one catalog for all the functional areas. That is the best practice, actually. Now, I'll again go to the purchasing. And then here, what happens, I'll now create one more thing. Now, find what else, you go there. So, otherwise, what happens, it's not allowing you to do the same thing on the second one. Fine, I click on it. I will now open it up. So, tools is the one I have done. Oh, sorry. I made a mistake. I'll now go to the, what happens, again, I'll merge purchasing. You go to this place. And then here, what I'm going to do is, I will now create one more category now. So, click on plus, now, fine. I will now say paint. Okay, fine. Something. There is a tool. Fine. A1 underscore paint. Paint is the category. Fine. Take a couple. So tools is the one I created, and then paint is the category. So for these two things, what happens? I want to have a different charge account now. And I want to have a different charge account. So click on the description and paste it now. And go there. Click on OK. So tools and paint are two categories. And then let me assign these categories to my items actually. Click on second close. Fine. Let me go there and then assign the categories to items. So click on done now. You go there and then you click on the home icon and then I will now create the item. Go to the product management. You go to the product information management. Go there, click on it. So let me go and then browse the item and then query my 50 and 51 item. So 50 will be tools now. Right? So I will not make it over there. Fine, the component item is starting on what? AA150. A15 and then give a tab number. So both items will be visible actually for me. Go there. So click on it, hide now. So 50th item, fine, go there on the master org. My master org is what, A10. So click on it and then I will now change the category to what, tools. So I will now change the category to tools. Open it up and then I will be changing the category to tools. Go down and then the categories. So when you assign one catalog to multiple functional area, there will be only one entry over here, remember. Click on it and then here I will now make a change now, drop it down. I will now make a search now, find tools and search for it. So I will now search for what? A1 and then make a search now, find tools, I will now put it over there. So this is the tools now, fine, click on okay now. I will now save it. So is the tools one. So Almoch Purchasing is having a tools category. Fine, give a save and close now. And then 51 item will be having what, paint actually. Go down and then 51. I'm going to have go for it.
No, purchasing category, we are assigning at master org level or child org level,
no? Because they are all controlled master level. Fine, go there. All categories has to be controlled at master org level. So don't make it as a child org level. Fine, master org level. The master org level. Click on it. One of my students has also made a mistake by putting it as a child org. Fine, he had got a lot of problems. Fine, always categories must be controlled the master org level. Fine, the categories. And then go there. And then here, go there and then make a change now. Fine, there's a paint I'm going to put in. I click on search and then I will now put the paint. It's A1 and then click on search now. The paint. I click on okay. Now save. So that is tools and then this is paint now. Now for tools, I'm not going to give one value. And then for paint, I'm going to give one value. Now you go to this place now. Fine. So you go to the shop. Shop has to be closed. Click on this one. So the transaction accounting definition is there. Click on it. So let us now come to the main area now. Fine, click on done now. And again, it's a basically scope specific one. On the procurement area, what happens? You have to come to this now. It's not visible actually. Fine. Again, come to financials and then come back again and go to the financials again. And then come back to procurement now. Drop it down and then go to the procurement now. The procurement. So here again, go to the transaction accounting area. Fine. Procurement again. Transaction accounting rules now. Fine. Go there. Click on it. And then here, I'm now going to create a mapping set. So let us now create a mapping set. Manage mapping set. I'm going to create a mapping set. So let us now create a management. Fine, click on plus now. I'm going to create a mapping set for the categories based. And I will now say click on A1 underscore map underscore set. I'm creating it now. Because the short name needs everything in caps or something like that. So this is output is not account combination. And go there. Output is only a, what happens, segment actually. Segment. So segment is an output now. So here, what happens? I'm going to add the input source actually. I'm going to add a segment. So go to actions and then go to select and add. So I'm now going to add a source. I'm going to sublinear application is purchasing now. I'm going to purchasing. And then here, source is item category. I'm going to query now. So item category is the one. Item category, click on search. So item category, I'm going to choose it now. I'm going to click on item category and then click on apply and then click on OK. So what is, I go there, click on the segment now. So item category is now coming now. So I will now add the chart of accounts over here now. Fine, click on the add chart of accounts. Let me add my chart of accounts. A1 is the chart of accounts. Drop it down and then press A. When it comes, stop me. A is coming. Oh, I made a wrong one now. A1. What is, go there. So here, what happens, go there and then I will now give a save at this stage. Now, fine, go there. Segment, drop it on which segment you want. I want to have the accounting segment also. Accounting segment, I'm putting it. So you put the chart of accounts as an accounting segment. Fine, go there. Click on save at this stage. Now, click on save. So my map set is now getting ready now. Click on save. In reality, whatever, you'll be having only one chart of accounts, not many. One or two, maybe. So click on plus now. Fine, I'll now add it. Click on plus. And then here it will be coming as a list of value item category. Fine, drop it down. And then I put the list now. Fine, go there. Click on search now. Search and then I will now say A1 and click on search now. Fine, I will now see the tools now. I will now see the tools. Please. If it is going to be tools on the purchase requisition or purchase order, what happens? I have created two accounts now. Fine, go there. I have created two accounts now. Fine. One is a 15 and 16. We have created now. Fine, I will not make it as a 15. 15. and then click on plus now. If it is the tools, it is 15 now. Right? Then click on plus, and then here, go there, and then drop it down, and then click on search. Now, move the paint over here now. Here you go. And then click on search now. Right? The paint I'm going to do. Paint I'm putting in. Okay. So paint is what? 16. I will not put it. So this is basically called category based charge accounts. And then add all the values, whatever you want over here. That's it. So the mapping set is ready. The tools and paints is now going to have 15 and 16. And then click on save and close. And remember, we have only two items now, right? Which are having this categories basically, whatever I have mentioned. Right? If you go there and say no. If it is going to be tools, it is 15. It is going to be paint, it is going to be 16. If any other item are having any other category, it will be what? For other item, it will be 1010. And then for the expense item, it will be 1600. Right. Only two categories have been defined. If you want, you have to clear away for all the categories. Clear on this now? So for tools, 15. And then for the paint, it is 16. And then for item which is not belonging to the category, it will be as per the normal ones only. As per the normal purchasing account defaulting, it will be coming. Now, let us now override this in my tab actually. Let us now override this in my tab. Anybody has got any doubts? Just then they're asking me.
In managed mapping sets, Nana, you need to choose the material account or the charge account, right? We didn't choose that, right? Last time
anything you can choose now. I have choose only the what happens, the account now. Only account. Only okay. The account segment I have modified. I can even modify the first segment or second segment also, whichever you want. So I am now modifying the third segment, the accounting segment, with my category based accounting. Now let me open up the tab now.
Sir, one small question here. Like in EBS, to achieve this, we need to do it through SLA or is there any
other? SLA only. Through SLA only you have to do it. I don't know how to customize SLA.
Isn't it not in EBS? It is the account generator workflow.
It is there. It is there. Whatever is there in EBS is also there in Fusion. Right? As far as accounting is concerned, every aspect of what happens in EBS is available there. But in EBS, what happens, you have to do via SLA. You need to have a SLA license. Then only you can do it. Otherwise, you cannot do it. Now here, what happens, no license is required. You can very well do it now. And everything can be done here. Now on the charge account, what happens, I have now put what? This one now. Fine. The one. So I have given what? A1 underscore, what happens, rule 1. In the rule 1, I am going to modify now. I will now modify the rule 1 now. And the rule 1 I have given as an override now. So let me modify the rule 1 now. So here, I go there. This is what's called managed mapping set now. Where is the rule 1 now? The one. I'll choose on the one. I don't know whether I have not gone it. So what happens? I will now come out of it. Let me go to the rule now. Fine. Go to the manage accounting rule. Or I have to open up one more tab region actually. Okay, let me open up one more tab region for this moment. So in this place, manage mapping set is there. I'm going to click on done now. Manage mapping set is now already completed now. Fine. We are now completed our map set actually. I'm going to click on done now. Come out of it. And then let us now go to the rules. So again, this is not visible actually. I don't know why it's so fine. I go to the financials and then I again come back. Go to the financials and then come back. And remember, they are all scope specific and then you have to choose the scope and then do it now. Fine. So click on the purchase accounting concept. Let us go to the manage accounting rules and then I'm going to modify my rule now. Go to the manage accounting rules. Let me modify my rule. So let me go there. This is my rule now. Fine. Edit now. So this rule is now having a constant here. This rule is now having a constant here. So let me change it to mapping set. So constant is not on the plan. I'm going to put a mapping set. So I will not drop it down. I will not put A1 and then give a tab now. And mapping set. So now this is now replaced by the mapping set actually. And then the mapping set is already, this rule is already on my tab actually. And give a save and close. The rule is already on the tab. So this is already set now. My rule is already on the tab. Now let us go there and then go to the what's called. We will now create what happens at requisition.
So sir, there is one more task. Manage accounting rule and this is manage account rule.
Oh God, there are two things are there? I don't know.
No. I mean to say, you are saying accounting rule. There are two different tasks. One is account rule and another is accounting rule.
No, see this now. Fine. One second.
This is account rule.
Rule now. Fine. Click on done now. And again, go back and come back to the fusions. Financials. And come again. Happens you go to the procurement. Go there. Click on it. Manage account rule is there. What else is there? Nothing else is there.
No, in finance, there is an accounting, manage accounting
rule. I don't know about finance. Again, you have to go to the finance and then see this. No, fine. and then again the finance. So the other modules and all, I don't know. I know only about this. Fine. Maybe that may manage account. You learn from financials actually. So if there are multiple things, what happens, you learn from managers. Now it's all set now. Fine, let us now go there and then we'll now create what happens, a requisition. My 50th item, what happens is now having, what happens, you go there, go to the procurement and then get a purchase requisition. Go to the requisition line, go there. Go there, it's what? A150. It has to be 15 now. And go there, click on it, and then go there, and then look at it. It has to be 15. 15 has come. We'll now go there and then change it also. We'll now see A151. It comes, it's okay. Otherwise, we'll come out and then go. It has to be 16 actually, because what happens? The category is paint actually. So for the paint category, what happens? They're going to have this one. And 16 has come. No, it's not come. Huh? We'll now add it and then see if I'm going to add to cart. And then see, it has to become 16 actually. Add to cart and then go there. Click on it. Click on review. It has to show as 16. It is 16. So this is on category based charge account. And remember, this is not the only way. There are multiple ways of doing it, actually. Fine. Financials are doing it in a very different manner, actually. You're going to see this now. Right? So I have told you in one way, but what happens? And if I put any other account, it will be 10, actually. Fine. You'll now go there, click on what happens, a shop now. If I put any other account which does not belong to the category, you can now see the 10 will be coming as per the default accounting. And if you go to the enter acquisition lines, and then I will now put something in. I'm trying to go to the A1, I will now put the first item. The first item, which do not belong to these two categories now, and in some other category. If it is in some other category, the default accounting will work, and then what happens, the 10 is coming. So as per this, what happens is 10. So for this, what happens, the asset item, and then for an expense item, 1,600. And then if the category space one is given, then what happens, that will override these accounts actually. That will override this account and then populate the appropriate account. If the category is not specified for a specific account, then what happens, it will not choose the default accounting. The default accounting will be chosen. Otherwise, what happens? The category based accounts will be coming and then defaulting go there. Got it? So 1010, 1006. Now let us go to the purchase orders. Fine. That is where my problem is. Requisitions coming properly, but in the purchase order, I don't know how to do that now. Fine. The charge account. Fine. Here, what happens? If I am putting a service based requisition, it has to come as 1007. It's coming very correctly in requisition. But this is not coming here now. Right? I don't know what is absent there in this purchase orders. And I don't have the document also, similar document also. In one. So click on the procurement. I will now go to the purchase orders. Click on purchase orders. Go there. Click on create. So click on create order. So go there. Everything is there. Fine. A1 is a supplier. Click on supplier. Supply side, everything is going. Click on create. Let me put both the items over here now. Then see this.
I think Nana in Fusion, what they've done, they've completely separated all the accounts to as a separate subject, right? I mean, earlier we used to have all the liability accounts in supplier, then we have the same in the org level, then the subunit level, everywhere, then it gets different. Now, these.
You have to learn it only from a supplier, actually. If you can learn it, it will be excellent, actually. So I will now put the first item over here. Now, fine, go there. It's the A150. Now, fine, 50 is another item. Fine, go there. So that will be giving you a category of what? Of 15 actually, and the charge amount. Fine, go there. Click on it. I will now put the quantity as what one. Click on one now. Everything will be coming. So everything is coming actually. It will come. One is there. Fine, go there. I will now go to the schedules and then give a date now. The purchase order level will give a date. Now you can see 15 will be coming now. Click on it. And then I will now give a save now. Give a save. Okay. So here, what happens? You go there. Go to the lines region. And then here, whatever they go there, go to the schedules. Fine, I have to see the accounts. Now, fine, go to the distributions. Fine, go to the distributions and have a look at the account. Click on it, and then click on edit now. You can now see 15 will be coming for us. So 15 is coming. 15 is coming. So similarly, when I put the expense account, 16 will be coming. But when I put the service data, it is not coming actually. The 1007 has to come. Now, fine, it is not coming. I click on add now. Go to the lines region, and then let me add it now. There is something has to be set up. I click on plus now, fine, go there, click on it. And then here, go there. And then I will make it as our fixed prices and services. This is basically a service item. It's a description based one. I'll not change it to fixed prices and services. Fine, go there. So description is what test now. So category, I will not put some category. Fine, go there. So description based will not be category based actually. Fine, I will not put some category. Starting A, 134. I will now say analog devices. So click on analog devices. Go there. So price is one. Go there. And now what happens? You go there and then save it. Saving itself, what happens? It will not throw all the errors actually. If you save it, what happens? It will not throw all the errors actually. It is now saying what happens? The account, variance account is not done. The charge account is not coming at all. The charge and variance accounts are not coming at all.
No, sir. Hello.
Yeah, tell me. Yeah.
Could you please go to the line level?
1 second.
Yeah.
So is what is I am in the line level only. I'm in the
and then click on view.
Yeah.
View. Click on view. Yes. And columns. Just select the column called requester.
Requester. Fine.
Yeah.
Your requester based. You are saying, no? Fine. Go there.
Correct. Yeah. Just select requester. Yes. Enter the requester value over here.
Oh, 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 oh.
Yeah.
Value, it will be coming 1007, you're saying, no? Fine. Excellent. Yeah. I will now say EMP1 space A1 now. Go there. Because no, the requester has been given a charge account, actually. Fine. Go there. It's what is good, good, good. You will save now. We'll now go to the accounts and then have a look at it. Fine. At least the charge account.
Before they try to validate it.
Mm-hmm. 1 second. We'll now go there and straight away see this now. Beautiful. Because requester only we are given the account now. Fine. Go there. Go to the distributions and have a look at it now. The distributions, what happens? You go there and then click on edit now. Go there and then see this. 1007 has to come now, but 1015 is only coming now.
Mm-hmm. Sir, can you please validate it and then?
Cancel. I'm in this proper one only now. Fine. Go there. I'm in the second line. No, I'm in the asset item. I have to be in this place.
Ah,
in the
correct.
Click on the test item.
Here it is showing 1007.
Yeah, yeah, here itself it is showing. Beautiful, beautiful. Fine, Satya, excellent now.
So, you know what? Actually,
the requester's name. Yeah, he was wondering what, why it's not coming. Oh, God. Fine, awesome.
We encountered the similar sort of issues, you know, and this is how actually, you know, Fusion is designed.
I was wondering, in request issues coming, it's not coming. I don't know how to do that now. Fine, I was struggling like anything now. Yeah.
Satya, one question I have is, does requester have any role for PO?
Maybe a requester of the PO only, not the PR requester. It's a PO requester actually.
Yeah.
No, the PO requester would obviously be the buyer, right?
Yeah, naturally is a buyer actually. So it has to pick up the buyer as such, no, fine. It's not picking the buyer.
We are sir, just to add on to what you said. Mm-hmm. In fact, actually, you know, we can keep the buyer as a requester over here if at all you are creating a PO.
Ah,
yeah. So what happens, you know, how to
make the buyer as a requester actually here?
No, sir. You know, here the buyer is, who is the buyer, sir, here? Employee one, right?
Employee one.
So just put the same, you know, buyer value as, you know, requester there in the line level.
Column has to be manually added, you're saying. Okay?
Yeah.
Requester need not be a buyer all the time, right?
See, what happens, you know.
If you put his charge account, will be coming. The line level, if you say, the people.
So it's nothing but the default expense account. Which is getting, you know, derived from, you know, from the employee level.
Once you put the request over here, then what happens? This charge account of 1007 is coming automatically. Beautiful, beautiful. And then here again, what happens if you go there and then click on it, fine, go and then edit now. Fine.
So if we change the request from employee one to employee two, or
employee two's account will be coming. Yes, exactly.
Okay.
I have not tested it, but the logic is correct.
Okay.
That's okay. And we have to give the different values over there. That means buyer and requester can be different. It seems so. So in this place, in the fixed places services, what happens? You go to the distribution, and then what happens? You will now see the accruals. You know,
yeah, in situations where it is different, it's called on behalf of orders. Mm-hmm. Somebody can order on behalf.
The description test item, what happens? I go to the distribution. So go there. Now what happens? This is now coming. 1011 is also coming now. Fine, is what is. So if you go on and see this place now, and if you go on and have a look at it now, fine. So we have given an expense accrual account that is available on the mapping set actually. So on the mapping set, what happens now? So when the expense, what happens is 1011 for all other items is 1001 actually. Fine, 1001 is a asset liability, asset accrual, and then 1011 is an expense accrual. Everything is defaulting. Good, good. Fine, all the things are already depending. Only thing is, I was worried about this now. Fine, this was not coming. I was wondering about how to do it. Fine, fortunately, Satya has solved it. Now, if you see this now, fine, they are all picking up from the mapping set actually. They're all picking up from the mapping set now. Fine, everything is now picking up from mapping set. Now, you will not see the default one now. Fine, you will not see, but how the default ones are. There. It's a very complex one actually. So, if you see this now, fine, for the charge account, this is a default accounting rule. Let us now go and then check this accounting rule about how it is written actually. You must, yeah.
If preparer prepares on behalf of requester, then how the...
When you're putting the requester, his charge account will come there. That's all. On the line level, if you're putting somebody as a requester, his charge account will be coming as a default expense account.
Okay.
Now, I have taken up the purchasing charge account for the charge account. I will not show you about how these rules are basically. So, this is really a very complex one. This is where I couldn't understand at all. It's a very difficult one, and everything is picking up from mapping sets actually. Go to the procurement. You will not have
a sir, in just in a nutshell, actually, how this TARD works. TARD is nothing but how the accounts getting generated, be it charge account or something. Yeah. So it sits at the top level. Mm. So in order to get it generated, the lowest level is mapping set.
Mm.
Once that is defined, then actually we need to define accounting rule. Mm-hmm. And then on top of that, actually you need to assign accounting rule to the TAD.
Exactly. So you go there. I'll now go to the manage accounting rules, and then I'll now show you the default one, which is how it is set actually. I'll go there, click on search now. You cannot modify the defaults one, you can only view it now, and you can even copy and then make your own now. I'll now see this now. Let us now have a look at it. So the charge account has got multiple layers now. First of all, it will now see the requisition charge account, and then it has got a condition. Writing the condition is a real skill of a consultant actually. This is what a financial team says. If this condition is not valid, this will not be applied. Then it will now go to the user preferred account. Fine, it has got a condition. So if this condition is not required, it will now go to this place. Go to this place. Likewise, what happens? It will now keep on going down. And writing condition is a real talent. And I will show you in one of my projects now, find out that how they have written it actually. So yeah, they have made their own mapping sets actually. Everything will now refer to a mapping set only. In this place, this condition refers to a mapping set actually. So that is how it comes. And this condition refers to adding that. And then here, if you go there, and then I will not show you, but how they have written. So let me log into my client's instance and I'll show it to you. They have created their own mapping set for this now. So everything they have created on their own now. So let us go on and have a look at it now. I will not go to this place, fine. Click on setup and maintenance. And they have written the conditions also. Maybe the document on TAD may teach you about how to write the conditions actually. Go there, I will not go to what? Manufacturing and supply chain management. And then here I will not go to the manufacturing set because everything is now, this thing now. Management mapping set, and go there, I will not go to the cost accounting now. The cost accounting, what happens? They have, for the financials, they have created their own mapping set section. And click on the management sets. They have created everything now. Everything is the condition actually. So they refer to that basically. And click on it. So they don't use the normal ones now. Fine. If you go on the EMA, if you make a query, and click on search. So this is how they write it actually. The cost of goods sold account is there. So they have made their own mapping set. Fine. Click on it now. Fine. If you go on and see, there will be a condition in the bottom. The condition refers to the appropriate one, and so what happens, you cannot do it. So now here what happens, the category based accounting actually, and the category based accounting. So they have made the category based cost of goods sold account, and there are 15 categories are there. So they have put the structure over here. This is the inventory category identifier is the source actually. For this, what happens, the value set is coming automatically. So for the value set, what happens, they're now getting everything. So if you go on and see that, what happens, the EMA cost of goods sold account, and then give a cancel number, this is how it is done now. So we'll now go on and have a look at how they have done it actually. The EMA cost of goods sold. So I will now go to that manage mapping set to find that is the one. It is not in this place. No, fine. I'll now go to the financials and then go to the manage mapping set. Now. I have to go in this place here, financials, accounting, budgetary control and encumbrance accounting. I don't know where to go now. So let me go on and via purchasing itself. I'll now see whether I'm able to go there or
not. No, sir, you can directly search over here, right?
In the search tab. Financials, yeah. Okay. Manage mapping set.
Yeah. Manage accounting rules, right?
I will now see the manage mapping set now. Manage accounting rules, no? Fine, yeah. I wanted to see what happens. My manage mapping set for let's say is payables, no? Fine, click on the payables. No? Manage mapping set. Oh, it shows only the data entry actually. No? Fine, let's click on it. I will not put EMA. It only shows the data entry or what? EMA cost of goods. So I have forgotten that actually. How to go there? There, what happens? They have written the role conditions actually. In the accounting rules, you are saying, no? Fine. In the accounting rules. Okay. I'll now go to the manage accounting rules. Manage. I wanted to learn it fully, but nobody is teaching me properly. I don't know. Good. Not payables, basically. I'll now go to the receivables. Not fine. The receivables. Manage accounting rules. I will now search on the EMA now. Nicely written. They take a longer time and then what happens is they do it very properly actually. They create their own rules, own mapping sets.
Nana sir, you can go to procurement and go for manage accounting rules.
Okay. I will now go to the procurement.
Yeah.
And then I will now go to the manage mapping set itself. Huh? Manage percentage.
No. Go to accounting rules.
Manage accounting rules.
Yes, accounting rules.
So any financial guys, you can make any value addition to become fine. What is that? I'll now go to the
first
procurement transaction account.
That is the one. Yes.
Procurement transaction. Who is this?
Lokesh here.
Lokesh, okay, fine. You go to the manage accounting rules. And then here what happens is all there. And if you go on and
this is the one, sir. Yes.
Accrual account rule. I'll now have a look at it.
So here you have conditions at the bottom. Yeah.
This is not having any condition actually. Well,
no. No, that depends upon the requirement. So if you go to other, if you go to natural account one, you can find something.
Budget distribution will not go there in the account. Oh, no condition.
Not.
Some more things that happen, they have put the conditions also.
Go to charge account, Nana sir. You will definitely find something. Yes. Second one.
Second one, okay.
Yeah.
So click on it and then you cannot see.
Because most of
the look at, do you know how to write the conditions at all?
Yeah, some way, something.
Some knowledge you are having it now.
Okay. Yeah. So this is a condition what they have written. So BU is equal to N and the definition type.
And
so
this represents a mapping set, isn't it?
Yes. It directly calls the mapping set, and this directly it is you can directly insert source and you can
There are multiple sources are available here. You can insert a source and then what happens? You can now write the conditions also.
Correct.
Condition writing is one. When I was discussing the financials, what happened? They were saying, fine, you have to put the appropriate conditions or the appropriate, what happens? Your mapping set gets invoked.
And I think writing condition is not a big deal. You need not have to have that SQL knowledge and all this. System will guide you on all the tasks, how to write.
Okay. It's all manually written. Na? Fine. You can use this and or, and then operators also. And then I put the brackets and all these things. You can do it, I think. So many operators are. We can keep on writing it. The cross BU. I think this has to be written manually, isn't it? That standard text, you only have to write, isn't it?
No, sir. Actually, you know, you can always, you know, get a copy from the standard one.
Aha.
And then actually, you can
Modify it. And then modify it wherever you want, actually.
Correct. And at times, what happens, you know, I'll tell out of my experience, you know, when you generally copy, you know, the whole condition from one of the role to the another one, you know, at times, you know, it might, you know, give you or throw some error. Another actually, you know, we'll have to, you know, pick up the options individually. I mean to say and or conditions. And after that, you need to validate it.
Good.
That source, when you click the source, it will give you the attributes, Nana, that answers your questions. Yeah.
So that's fine now. Fine. We'll now stop for a break, actually, a coffee break now. So it's now 7:40 in India. And so what happens? We'll be back at 7:55 now. At 7:55, we'll be back now. This is a small break. 15 minutes break now. 7:55 means what? It is a 10:25 actually. In Eastern, it is 10:25. Let me stop it.